Oh, we're at Redcliffe area and we're just parked and it's chaotic parking, but this is the Kite Festival. 27th of August 2016, and you're not going to believe it. Emma's looking good, but Lottie's got this funny little hat on, you know, this funny little, like an umbrella hat. But anyway, we're going to make a little movie of that visit. There you are, there's the umbrella hat. Fantastic, isn't it? Oh, well, we're getting closer to where we've got to get in and pay the money and enter. I guess over to the right here. And there's some of the kites. Come on, we're coming here somewhere. Anyway, I'll take a bit more as we go. Very, very, very big crowds here, though. I think if you said 10,000, it'd have to be probably 10,000, you know? Entry gate, here we are, there's an entry gate. Cash and card accepted, there you go. All right, this is how we get in, and it's a big event. This is a really big event, as I said. That's not a kite, you can see them up there. See if I can. When we get the computer fixed, I can put it up on Facebook. And we saw some advertising for Rodeo, which I've never been to, so we'll go and have a look at that in October.
Now there's a fact of life in Kite Fest, and that is that we all fear the transporting tree of Charlie Brown fame. And what you'll have noticed is before, with a change of wind, one of the lifting kites came down into the tree. And as is the nature of our kite flying friends, we all come to help and make sure that we save those kites, because one of those lifting kites is just $100,000, so we don't want to see those.
Morton Bay, there we have a look at.
You got a nap top good today. If you want to impress me.
Come down those kites. So-called entertainment, green machine, you know, it's all propaganda for greenhouse gases, global warming and rubbish like that. And anyway, you got to have these propaganda merchants around here somewhere, and here they are.
By slapping our hands together,
we'll
save our planet.
saying 10,000 a year before. That's way understatement in my opinion. There's a lot of people here today. Keep more of the kites afterwards while we can't look at. And there's some of them are crocodiles or stingrays or whatever. All kinds of things here. Some of these lollies here, pretty tempting. And a lot of other stores along the way too.
So do make sure you check out the Kite Fest Kids Zone. In that area also, if you do have the babies or toddlers that you would like to use some
food,
there's a bunch of pigeons here, look. Pigeons. They're all lined up like a bunch of pigeons here. And having some of that loaded chips. Have a look at this load. My overseas friends, take this loaded, just check these chips out. There's bacon and cheese. There you go. There's a little Adele, gonna have a chip.
And Amy.
A bit of aerobatics if I can try and get a reasonable angle at the moment. On the Redcliffe station, the 690 is just leaving. We've got off that from Redcliffe. And of course it rang late and the people wanting to catch a train just missed one approximately 30 seconds ago. This is the railway station at Sandbay. And I may take a trip out to Shorncliffe, which is the end of this line, and then head back by bus to Sandgate. Today is Sunday the 28th of August 2016, by the way, and I'm looking at the double track there parked towards Brisbane.
The Shorncliffe train stopping all stations will arrive on platform 1.
in approximately 2 minutes. Please wait behind the yellow safety line until the kite has stopped.
Yes, well, you've heard the announcement on one platform, one now awaiting a train to Shorncliffe. It's only one station, quite literally. It's a couple of k's up the line of single track. It's a standard six car EMU, and by the way, for my friends overseas, this is 3'6" gauge and 25,000 volt AC. Train is practically empty because nearly everybody gets off here in Sandgate. We're heading out now to Shorncliffe. And it was opened in 1882 and was the first purely suburban train line created in Brisbane. Saying it's extremely short run, literally a 2 minute run into Shorncliffe. Single track, and it does continue a little bit further on because they used to turn trains here and store trains. And there's a turning triangle which is not electrified. And here we are arriving at Shorncliffe platform. Shorncliffe station, here's the train, and an interesting station, quite fairly old too, I'd say. I'm not sure if it goes right back to 1882 on the opening, but it could be. I'll inquire about it, but I've got a feeling that it's obviously rebuilt from the original. And I'll take this train for the, literally for the 2 minute trip down to Sandgate, get a bus back to Redcliffe. It's just looking along the track a little bit to the end of the line, which would only be a couple of train lengths up, and very gradually we'll have a bit of a look here and we can see the turning triangle, otherwise known as a Y to the Americans and many even people in Australia. So there's the Y, which, as I said, is non-electrified, and so diesel engines or steam engines could use that Y. And here's the train. I'll be boarding the train very shortly and heading off. There's some golfers, or obviously next to the golf course. Just leaving Shorncliffe. See the other end of the triangle up there coming in over the lake. I wouldn't think it was used that often, see? It's a quite old style, man. It's a nice home, actually. Thank you. 90 buses due in a few minutes, so I've got about 8-10 people here, I suppose, waiting on it. And it says Clontarf, but in reality it goes into Redcliffe and then around into Clontarf. So this bus exchange has got quite a number of routes operating out of it, say. A variety of places, during the weekdays in particular. Right, sunny winter's day here today. In fact, I need a hat. It's pretty warm. Here comes the 690 bus to go to Redcliffe. Waiting across the road. Very difficult to estimate, but it could be anything up to 30,000 or 40,000 people here. yesterday and today, I assume. And it's cordoned off by police and witches' hats and all the rest of it. You can't just turn and you can't, certainly can't park just anywhere. So here again is the site and here's the kites. Quite extraordinary. Bay is just ahead and I'm about to go around the corner quite literally and just get those lights there and go back to Kathleen and Joe's house, the old house, and finish off my little excursion down to Sandgate and Shauncliffe. Well, this is known as the Redcliffe Lagoon, a safe swimming beach, mainly I guess for children would be very safe and very good. No nasties in here, no sharks, no crocodiles, no stingers, no sea snakes. Anyway guys, I'm only half joking. Got Kathleen and Brett walking along out there and then Martin. And it's just a good little spot for people to have a look at and get swimming in. No diving and no jumping. Oh, there you go. Better view, but you might say it's nice. Good to go for a bit of a walk along the bay. It's getting a little late in the afternoon and a bit later it won't really be suitable for taking movies, but this is a little view as the sun is slowly disappearing, let's say. Apparently Martin's gonna, he's got his scooter, he's had a bit of a go at that. Well, they do their skating and rollerblading and all the rest of it, so there we go. There's some barbecue and some seats and tables and a little bird and all the rest of it. And people come here and have picnics and barbecues. Redcliffe Surf Life Saving Club. Okay. So it's pretty nice, you know. I really do like the area. There's a nice venue. Kathleen was talking about people could get married there. People could have their receptions there. I thought the price was a little bit high, but it's just one of the places worthwhile considering in Redcliffe. And just right across here on the beach, here's the beach. Here's a little bit of sand they got on the beach. And here is Orton Bay. You're not going to believe this, but they're sailing what is called the smallest kites in the world. Here they are. Barely see them. And they were selling those yesterday for $5 each at the Kite Fest. There you go. It's funny, isn't it, eh? $5 a kite. Some more kite flying. Flying up and flying up.